Hi everyone, thanks for watching this video. In today's video, I'm going to walk you through on how to present accuracy feedback based on key presses and mouse clicks. Now I'm going to first start with key presses. And then in order to determine if the answer was correct or not, we're going to also have a column has the correct answer. I'm just going to name this correct answer, and then this would be left and this would be right. And then I'll just set leave and reps here to 5. And then I'm going to click on here and select the conditions file. Now, if you see here, it's going to have the two column headers, which is stimuli and corons, and that's fine. And then, so now we're going to click on our text component again. And then we'll just do this and set it to every repeat. And then click OK. And then for key res, so if you click on data and click store correct, it's going to let you have a field where you can just type in corons. And then I'm going to click on OK. So now, hopefully, we will have an experiment that shows, well, please press left or please press right. And then we're going to press either left or right, and it will move on to the next trial. Right, I'm going to press right, and I'm going to press left, and left, right, left, right. Okay, so let's look at the data file. So this is going to say keyres.car, and 1 means that I pressed on the right key, and 0 means I pressed on the wrong key. And we're going to use this keyres.car now to, as part of a code component, we're going to create to show accuracy feedback. And to show feedback, we're going to insert another routine, and let's call this feedback. And so I'm going to click on this, it's going to be an empty routine. And the first thing we're going to do is click on customs here and click on code. So in our begin experiment routine, we're just going to type in this variable, which it, and I'm going to type in the double quotation marks so that it would represent a string that we're going to present. And so in the begin routine, so remember how we talked about the key underscore res.car? So we're going to use it right here. So if key underscore res.car colon. And then our variable just now for the message was msg. So I'm going to put msg equals, correct. Oh. Sorry, can't spell. So this will be so if the answer is correct, you show the message correct, and then we're gonna end this with else. Show that it's incorrect. So now that we have our code component, I'm just going to click on OK. And we're going to need a text component to present our text. And since we named our message as MSG, we're going to use a dollar sign here with an MSG to call on the variable. And then we're going to set this to every repeat. And I want my feedback to last for 2 seconds. So I'm just going to change this to 2. And then I'll click on OK. And hopefully now when I run this task, it will show me whether I got the trials correct or wrong. And then so I'm going to press on left now. And then it will say correct. And I'm going to try and give the wrong answer. So instead of pressing on right, I'm going to press on left. It's going to say incorrect. So this is how we show accuracy feedback using PRES. So now I'm going to show you on how to provide accuracy feedback using mouse clicks. To collect the response, I would need two buttons, either the left button or a right button. And before I started making this video, I've already made two here called the left button. So it's just an L, and then the right button, which is just a R. So I'm gonna now insert two images. So I'm gonna name this L. And then I'm going to click on here and click on the left button. And I'm going to leave this at constant because I want this to be the same image in every trial. And then for duration, I also want it to appear indefinitely along with the stimuli. So I'm going to click on OK. And then for the right button, I'm just going to click on another image component. And then I'm going to name this R for the right button. I'll leave this as indefinite, and I've chosen the right button, and then I'm going to click on OK. And then to be able to click on these images, I'm going to now select a mouse component, and I'll leave this as mouse, and then I'm going to set this to indefinite. Now, I want to also end the routine only when they click on either the left or the right button, so I'm going to choose valid click. And then for clickable stimuli, the only thing that I want them to click is the left button or the right button. So these are the names of the components, and I'm going to type these in here. And then for data, I would like to save it on click. So the moment they click on the stimuli, that's when they save the data. And I'm going to click on OK now. So hopefully when I run this task, It will be clickable, and I can have clickable stimuli. Right, perfect. So now it's going to say, please press right. So I press right, and it ended the routine and went on to the next. I'm going to press on left now, and then that's it. So now I have clickable images that ends on the routine. But these do not actually store accuracy yet. So what it does is that it stores what it was clicked and the time that the button was clicked. So you would see here the time would be in mouse.time, and then what was clicked would be mouse.click_name. So if I clicked on the right button, it would just say R. If I clicked on the left button, it would just say left. And now we're gonna use this mouse.click_name to first of all store the correct answer, and then secondly to provide the feedback for accuracy. So let's go back to our trial routine. Now we're gonna add another code component, and I'm gonna call this check correct, because we wanna check the correct answer. And now I'm gonna click on the end routine tab. Now, the reason why I'm doing this is because you would only know if the answer is correct or not after you've made the click. So, which is why it is at the end of the routine where you do this. And in order to write this code, I'll go if mouse.click_name. So that was the column as what was clicked, as we saw in the CSV file previously, and then square brackets 0 equals to core ans. If the what was clicked is equals to the core ans, I'm gonna put correct equals to 1, and then else correct equals to 0. And then so what this does is that it keeps track on whether what you clicked was correct or wrong. But and then in order to save this data in our CSV output, we would just need to add this. So there's going to be two parameters when we use this exp.addData. The first one would be the name of your column. So I'm just going to name the column as correct answer. And then I'm going to click press on the comma. And so the variable that we're trying to save is correct. So I'm just going to type correct here. And then I'm going to click on OK. And before we continue on, I would like to point out that this char ons here has not been defined yet in our Excel sheet. So I'm going to do that now. So it's the same as char ons, but instead of left and right now, we're going to do L and R because that is the name of our image components. And I'm going to save this and I'm going to close this. And then now we're going to reinsert our feedback routine. And again, we just leave this MSG variable here because that's just going to show our message. And then at the begin routine, instead of if key underscore res.car, we're just going to change this to if correct equals equals one. Let me speak this out here. So what this means that is if correct was one, you show the message correct. Else, so if it's not one, you're gonna show incorrect. And hopefully that should do the trick. So I'm gonna click on right now, it's gonna say correct. And I'm gonna click on right again, even though it says left. And it will say incorrect. So, and that's it. So this is how you would provide accuracy feedback based on key presses and mouse clicks. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope to see you again. Bye.